Have you ever stared at a blank canvas and just went, what do I do? Let's fix that. Hello everyone, Tim here, and today we're going to walk through an amazing tool made by Bluehost, the sponsor of this video, that will give you the foundation for building your website from scratch so they can do all the heavy lifting and build the framework while you can focus on your brand, your design, and get your website up and running significantly faster than you normally would. We'll walk through it step by step just to show you how efficient this tool is, so check the link in the description or go to bluehost.com/KevinStratvert to get an exclusive deal and to follow along. And with that, let's dive in. When you open the link, you'll be taken to this page which shows you each plan and each of the benefits. And this affiliate link will give you a special $199 a month deal on the basic plan for a year, which is amazing to start out on. When you decide you would like to upgrade, the Choice Plus and e-commerce options offer great scalability options, including many more websites, significantly more storage, and much faster storage on the e-commerce plan specifically to handle heavier and more frequent traffic, as well as some additional security and backup features for more peace of mind and safety. The e-commerce plan also features additional services and tools that are very useful if you're creating and selling courses, you're scaling up to a larger business, or you sell a lot of products online. We'll stick with the basic today for this tutorial and go ahead and choose that plan. And you'll be taken to this domain setup page initially, which you can walk through the steps for if you want to, but I'm going to go ahead and skip this for now by choosing Choose Domain Later. After that, you can run through checkout, put in all your information, and you're good to go to log in to Bluehost. When you first log into Bluehost, you may see a pop-up that shows that it is installing WordPress. If that's the case, you can wait on the next page and skip this step of adding the site. But just to show it here, we can select Add Site on both the Hosting and Websites pages. And we can make sure we install WordPress, hit Continue, give our site a name. We'll go with Tim's Tasty Treats. Hit continue, and again, we're going to skip setting up the domain name for now. And once you click on that, it'll run through the WordPress installation. And once it does, we can select log into WordPress. Now here's where we have the option to select the tool that we're going to take a look at today, the AI site creator. You also have the option to import a WordPress site if you already have one created, or if you're following a separate tutorial, you can go straight to the dashboard from here. But we're going to go ahead and click on this AI site creator to see exactly what it can do. So first off, we have a text prompt where we can tell the site creator what kind of website we're looking to make, who it's for, if it's for an individual or business, what the ideal design is, for example, what the overall style we want, whether it's modern, retro, etc. And this is going to give us the building blocks we need to add or change any branding, colors, imagery, text titles, whatever it may be, but to do so without having to build it all from scratch. So I'll go ahead and just paste in this prompt right here, and let's see what it makes for us. And here we can decide if we want to add our logo now. I'll go ahead and add the absolutely official Tim's Tasty Treats logo. If you don't have a logo ready, you can just hit skip for now. And then on this page, you can choose how familiar you are with WordPress. And this can be useful if you want to hide some beginner related features if you're already used to WordPress. But for this tutorial, we'll select beginner. So now we have our first look at what the site creator generates. And there are three separate options that differ slightly in build and layout. We can select the favorite one that we like the most. So let's say I like version 3 here. We can favorite that one. Or if one of them is close to what we want, but maybe just needs some slight tweaks, we can regenerate that particular design for a fresh variant. Now, if we hover over our designs, we can see we can preview the full version of the site. So we'll go ahead and select this one to preview it. And we can still take a look at each of the other ones as well by just hitting this drop down and selecting View All. And we see each of our versions, including the one that we regenerated. And we can still go into any of the other ones and regenerate those as needed. So let's go back into our site and let's just view the full version. We can go ahead and just scroll down, see if there's anything about it we like, don't like in particular. I think it looks pretty good so far. And just to be sure, we can go see the other ones that it generated just to see what those look like. I'm thinking I probably like the version 3 the most for now. Let's just see the regenerated one, see if there's anything slightly different about the layout that I like. It looks like it mostly just redesigned the colors. I think the original version 3 is the one I like the most. And if we want to make any refinements to the color or font of the overall template, we can go to Customize and finish out the template from there. Maybe change the colors around if there's a different theme that we want to go with. Personally, I do like the little bit more vibrancy of this one. And we can also change the overall font. And there are plenty more fonts that we can select as well. And there's also customized colors if we decide to do so from there. But once we have our ideal selection, we can go ahead and hit save and continue. This will import the site into WordPress and bring you back to the admin page with our site preview here. Let's make additional modifications by selecting Edit Your Site. And here's the WordPress editor interface. Right away, you can see the settings tab. And just as a quick note, if at any point you make a mistake, you can select undo or hit Control Z. Or if you want to revert back to a previous save, there will be a revisions number in this page tab and you can restore a previous version that way. So let's just say we move this whole block down here for whatever reason, we hit save. Now if we go back to our page block, there will be a revisions with how many revisions we've done. And we can select that revisions, go to this page, and let's go back to the previous version because I don't want to have that thing below where it was, and it'll restore the previous state. And then we can hit save. Up here in the top left, we have a few editor options. The first thing we'll look at is the document overview. And this list view here will show the entire page and its contents. So we can easily go into any group within the page and see what elements are inside of each group. We can move them around. We can change the block settings or edit and replace the contents. And a great aspect to this is anytime you click on any part of your page, it'll highlight that particular element in the list and show you where it is located. And if you're SEO focused, you also have this outline page where you can adjust all of your headings to make sure they all structurally make sense. We'll come back to this document overview in a moment. The second is the block inserter. And this is where we can add any templated element or widget to our page. And as we scroll down, you can see as we hover our mouse over each option, we get a preview window showing what that particular option looks like. And adding it to our page is as simple as dragging and dropping. You also have the patterns and media tabs for any pre-designed collections, images, graphics, or video that you favorited and would like quick access to. Now you've probably seen WonderBlocks continuing to appear in several places, and that's because WonderBlocks are the backbone for the site generation. What Bluehost has done with these is essentially take what WordPress has done really well and bundled it into a cohesive library. So if there's an additional block you want to add, you can certainly find those blocks here. So let's say we needed to add a pricing table. Well, we can go right into here and choose a design that best fits what we're looking for. And these are still fully customizable after you add them. I'll go ahead and add this one for now. Coming over here to the top right, we have our different views, so we can preview what a live page looks like, or switch our viewing device to see what it looks like on tablet or mobile. And we can select desktop to go back to our original view. And we can also enable show template to modify our header and footer. If we go back to our list view, we can see we have access to our header and footer now. And then we can disable the show template if we want to go back to editing just the content. And then we have our settings tab, which is open by default right here. And this is where we can select any one of these and customize the specific layout behaviors, add background effects, or add entrance animations. The entrance animations is the one I really like in particular because it adds just a little bit of extra finesse to your page. For example, let's go to our little pricing tab over here. And let's say we wanted to have each of these pricing boxes fade in one after another. Well, we can go into our list view here and drop down pricing, drop down columns, and now we see all three of our columns individually. So we can select the first one, go to entrance animations, and then select animation fade in bottom short. And then we'll go ahead and just add a 150 millisecond delay on that one. And then we're going to do the same thing for the second two, except for the delay, we're going to add just a little bit more onto each one so that they fade in not at the same time, but one after another. And now that we've made the changes, we'll go ahead and go up here and save it. And then we'll preview the page. And after it loads, we scroll down. We can see that we have a nice clean fade on that was super easy to create. And each part of this was added after our site was generated. just showing how easy it is to put the stuff in and create a nice clean template. So let's go back into our site editor here, and let's go back to the list view to see what more we can do with this. Now, I showed this briefly earlier, but let's say you wanted to move something around. So let's say I have a column down here that I wanted to move into a separate group. Well, I could click and drag this down to this column here, and now it'll place it in between. Now, I wouldn't necessarily want to do that in this case, so I can just come back here and undo, and that'll automatically put it back where it belongs. But it's super easy to move things around just by clicking and dragging. You can also do this from the page view itself by clicking and dragging and moving it along like this. But having the list view makes it much easier to see what's moving and where. It's also much easier to add layers, groups, or whatever else you're wanting to add by right-clicking on any element. So we'll just take this columns, for example, and then selecting Add Before or After. So if I select Before, that's going to add something above this column, or if I right-click this and select Add After, it'll add an element below it. This gives you much easier control over actually placing elements where you want them, and we can still swap them back and forth really easily, like so. If you accidentally added something, or you simply just want to remove any element or group, you can either right-click it and select Delete, or just highlight and press Backspace or Delete on your keyboard. And this is a basic overview of the site editor, and there are plenty more features that you can utilize for fine-tuning and creating, but for now we're going to go ahead and save our changes, and then we're going to go back to our WordPress pages from here. And on this page, we can actually see all of our pages that the template has generated. So if we wanted to modify a specific page, we can just hover down to whichever page we want and go to Edit. And that'll bring us back into our same WordPress editor. And we can scroll down and do everything that we just did on the main page. We'll go back to the main pages for now. And this is where you can start fully fleshing out how your site works and what pages you want. If you would like to check out and install new themes, we can go down to Appearance and Themes. And you can select Add Theme and browse the various different templates that you can add to your library. Or you can select Build with AI, and that'll build a new template from scratch. And if you want to go back to your editor, we can go ahead and go back here. We can either go to the Bluehost tab and select Edit Your Site, or we can go to our dashboard, scroll down, and check out Edit Site from the site preview. And if you want to place your site under construction, you can enable this coming soon. And then when you actually preview it, you'll get this tab that says Site Preview. This site is not live. Only admins can see this view. That way, nobody can actively visit your page as you are editing it. And then when you're ready to have it go back live again, you can just select Launch Site. And now people can visit the site again. And there you have it. You just created a solid foundation for your website in minutes. And it was that easy. Now, this isn't prompted or anything, but when I was originally speaking to Bluehost about this service, I actually told them that this tool made me genuinely excited about building a website, and I hope you can see why. I also hope this tutorial was helpful and valuable for you. Let me know in the comments what you thought about this, and thank you so much for watching. This is Tim, signing off.